Okay, so good morning. So since yesterday's class, we started looking at static stability, the stability of an air parcel if it is pushed from its original position. As you all know, this has got to do something with the buoyancy force, and the buoyancy is, or the difference in the buoyancy force, which is related to the difference intensities. The difference intensity is related to the difference in temperatures and so on. And so the difference in temperature is brought out by the difference in the lapse rate. Are you getting the point? The difference in temperature is brought out by the difference in the lapse rate. Why is there a difference in the lapse rate? The air parcel will follow the gamma d. The air will follow gamma. The air parcel will follow gamma d till it is saturated. After that, it may follow gamma s. That is why when you consider static stability, you have to first subdivide into static stability for unsaturated air and static stability for saturated air. In yesterday's class, we looked at static stability for unsaturated air, right? So please recall this diagram. For the sake of completeness, I will go through this again. This is the height. There is a point O. The air parcel is at its equilibrium initially at point O, and this was the parcel, right? This was air. So the parcel has got a lapse rate of gamma d. The air has got a What is generally gamma d value? Gamma d is 6. 9 point? C. G by Cp, yeah? Correct? So, approx 9.8 Kelvin per kilometer. This may be 4, 5, 6. This cannot be obtained from theory. This has to be obtained by measurements. A good way to get it is from radio sonde. We are now trying whether from satellites also we can get it. In fact, one of the projects which I am doing for INSAT 3D is to get this gamma using an infrared sounder, and then solve the radiative transfer equation, and then using the radiative transfer equation find out what will be the radiance to be captured by the top of the satellite. Keep on correcting the temperature profile till such time you get a temperature profile which, when substituted into the radiative transfer equation, will give a radiation intensity at the top of the atmosphere as picked up by the satellite, which will be closer to the measurements. This will not be done in one channel, this will be done in several channels. This is called passive remote sensing. We will look at it in a little more detail when we actually go to the chapter on radiative heat transfer of the atmosphere. Okay. So this is O, and then we took a case where this parcel is lifted up. And this was A, this was B, correct? So gamma is less than gamma D. Though the yellow line looks steeper, it is a height versus temperature, okay? And then T is what we said. So if the parcel is lifted up from O, left to itself, it will come back to its original position, okay? So it is So when the passer is pushed up, so this is called positive static stability. Okay. So the restoring force I'll clean this up. So gamma less than gamma d, yeah? Okay. Greater the gamma d minus gamma, greater will be the restoring force which will bring it back to O. Are you getting the point? So this is very important. Okay. Now, for the sake of completeness, we will have to draw the second figure where it is negative stability. Instead of negative stability, we can call it instability. Okay, please draw that figure. Yeah, please draw the. So it is negative static stability or simply instability. So this is okay. By the same token, people who missed yesterday's class, by the same token, instead of pushing it up, you push it down. Then what will happen is, this TC will be less than TB, TD, and then you can have the same arguments, and then actually it will become denser or something, or lighter. It will become lighter, it will go back to its original. All right. So whether it is displaced, pushed up or pushed down, it will always come back to O. So there is a possibility that it can oscillate around O, and we'll have to find out that natural frequency. That natural frequency, as I told you yesterday, is named the Brunt-Vaisala frequency in honor of the two scientists, Brunt, B-R-U-N-T, and Vaisala, V-A-I-S-A-L-A. So actually the radio sonde balloons are called the Vaisala sondes, because this family started the company, and then they are now that Vaisala company, it is in that Scandinavia. So Vaisala sounders are popular. Radio sondes are popular all over the world. Okay. Now I will use this part of the board. Height. Okay. So initially it's both the parcel and the air are at equilibrium at O. You are pushing the parcel little up. A was always the temperature of the parcel, correct? This is ओके रोए so the parcel will go out of control. You push it up, it will try to go up, right? Okay, so unstable parcel. So negative static stability or instability. All right. Any doubt so far? Okay. Problem number, next one. 39. Problem 39, please take it down. An unsaturated air parcel has a density of rho plus, temperature T plus. And the pressure and the density and temperature of the surrounding air are, sorry, an unsaturated air parcel has density rho plus and temperature T plus. And the density and temperature of the ambient air are rho and T respectively. Derive an expression. Rho plus T plus. Rho and T, rho plus T plus for parcel, rho and T for surrounding air, full stop. Derive an expression for the upward acceleration. Derive an expression for the upward acceleration of the air parcel in terms of you need to get the figure out the expression for acceleration. So the variables are z is the height. So dz by dt will give you velocity. D by dt of dz by dt will give you acceleration, which can be taken as d square z by dt square. So do the force balance, get an expression for the use the ideal gas equation, whatever you want, hydrostatic equation, whatever is you feel is relevant. Use all this and get an expression. Then we will proceed to problem 40, where we will solve the ODE and get the frequency. That frequency will be the Brunt-Weissala frequency. So we are considering this situation. No, some situation, doesn't matter. Let's look at net upward force acting on unit volume of an air parcel. F equal to rho V is mass into G is weight is the force, all right. So, one is the volume. Did I make a mistake? Rho or rho plus?
Rho plus.
Watch out, because we are looking at the parcel. Okay. Is it okay?
So if the first one is one unit volume force, so the next one, like F equal to M is M by, is it supposed to be M by rho, right?
Why M by rho?
Yeah, the first one is net upward force acting on per unit volume.
Yeah, I multiplied no into one.
Unit volume one.
It's fine, no? No, dimensionally it is consistent. Yeah, that 1 and 1 is getting cancelled, right? So, what is your problem? You can make it 2, 3, 4.1, whatever you want. Now, it should be small, that is important, right? Because otherwise, you cannot lump the properties, right? Please remember from the definition of an air parcel, the pressure in an air parcel adjusts to the pressure of the surroundings. Temperature will not adjust. Okay. Is it okay? Okay. So, the simple expression which gives the acceleration of an air parcel, greater T plus minus T, which is a consequence of gamma D minus gamma, that will be more will be the force. All right. So, strictly speaking, instead of T, what should be used? Instead of T, TV should be used. The virtual temperature should be used. But we already saw that virtual TV minus T is only 0.1123 Kelvin. So, for all practical purposes, the TV can be approximately equal to T, and then we will use the, because it is more difficult to work with the virtual temperature. So, we will work with the actual temperature. All right. So, problem number 40. Problem number 40, the air parcel discussed in problem 39. The air parcel discussed in problem 39 is now displaced. The air parcel discussed in problem 39 is now displaced upward from its equilibrium position. By a distance z plus from its equilibrium position z naught. Okay, is displaced upwards from its equilibrium position by a distance z plus from its equilibrium position z naught. That is z plus equal to z minus z naught. Okay. To a new level where the ambient temperature is capital T, to a new level where the temperature is T. The air parcel is then released to a new level where the ambient temperature is T. The air parcel is then released. Derive an expression to a new level where the ambient temperature is T. The air parcel is then released. Derive an expression that describes the subsequent. Derive an expression that describes the subsequent vertical displacement of the air parcel as a function of time. Derive an expression that describes the subsequent vertical displacement of the air parcel as a function of time in terms of T, gamma and gamma D, in terms of T, comma, gamma and gamma D. Try this. Okay. So, in the interest of time, I just wait for a minute. You just start. Let there be a phase lag. I will start working. Then you don't follow me. You will just cross check. That's all. Right? You can start now. Now, T naught minus T is the environmental temperature. It will follow, what is its dharma? It will follow gamma or gamma D? Gamma. Gamma into? Let us not complicate dz, we will keep it as z. Huh? Z?
Plus.
Z plus, I said.
Z plus
is okay. So, I am in my notes, I have z dash, does not matter. Z plus, fine, z plus. Okay, this will be, you want to keep it as T plus or? T. T plus will be for the parcel. Minus? Bhaiya. Therefore, T plus minus T equal to? I want to use it here. You able to see the logic? I want to get there. Therefore, what is this now? Very good. D square z by dt square is the same as d square z plus by dt square. Correct, huh? If you change it to, because z naught is constant, no problem, right? I can change the variable. Therefore, I substitute in, I will substitute in 9. Minus g. What do you get? T, yeah?
By T.
By T. I keep the T, no problem. Okay, so I have taken it as plus. Okay, we will bring it to the other side. I call it as n squared z plus, where n squared is this, okay. Check the units of n. Please check the units of n. It will be radian per second. Is it 1 by second or?
1 by second.
Got the units of frequency? So that n is called the Brunt Weissala frequency. Okay. So n. I'll give you some tidbits on Sir David Brunt. English meteorologist Sir David Brunt. He was a Finnish meteorologist who developed a lot of instruments. So it is called the Brunt-Weissala frequency. He lived too much, huh? What is your problem? Huh? Almost there, no? He might have registered for the course also. Or he might have offered the course. This will be edited. Okay. Equation 12 is what? Mathematically. It's a second order ordinary differential equation. Please note it down. Equation 12 is a second order ODE. Equation 12 is a second order ODE and Equation 12 is second order ODE, and if gamma d is greater than gamma, n will be real. Okay? If gamma d is greater than gamma, that is gamma is less than gamma d, which means positive static stability. If positive static stability condition is satisfied, gamma is less than gamma d. Therefore, gamma d minus gamma is positive, n is real. Please find the roots of the equation. Please find the solution to equation 12. For the case of real n, please find the solution. You require two initial conditions because it's second order. So I know at t equal to 0, z plus is z plus of 0 and initial velocity is 0. At t equal to 0, z plus is z plus of 0, right? I'll give you the conditions. Board is moving. Okay. What is the solution? Agreed?
Yes.
Correct? Now, we have to get the two constants. Initially, you are giving only displacement, but velocity is 0. Please find out A and B. I will give you 2 minutes. Please get A and B. So, I will write. You can show this. Please get A and B. People who got it, just hang on for 2 minutes. First, you should recognize it's a periodic solution. Okay? And n is the frequency, characteristic frequency. So, this air parcel will oscillate with a characteristic frequency that is decided by the value of n. And n of the many things, n is dependent on g, rho d minus rho and t. G is not under our control. Therefore, gamma d minus gamma and t also will be 280, 290. So, that gamma d minus gamma will be the singularly most important factor which will decide, okay, the response of the system to an initial disturbance. And greater the value of n, greater will be the stability, it will get restored. So, the Brunt-Weissala frequency is a characteristic measure of the stability of the air parcel, okay. So, the Brunt-Weissala frequency is a good measure of the stability. Greater the Brunt-Weissala frequency, more stable it is. Is it okay? Now, let us complete this. Therefore, if an unsaturated air parcel is originally at its equilibrium level O, it is pushed and it is given a displacement, initial displacement of z plus of 0, then it will execute oscillations, periodic oscillations with a frequency n given by g gamma d minus gamma by t whole to the power of half, which is called the Brunt-Weisala frequency, and an amplitude which is given by the initial displacement. Higher the Brunt-Weisala frequency, greater will be the stability of the air parcel. So this gives us an idea about the stability of the air parcel. Okay, so we can say in the next class, what we will do is, we will take a layer of air which is flowing through some mountains, and I will give you some gaps, the characteristic length between the mountains. Then you can find out what will be the characteristic time period and the frequency. Then if there is some disturbance in the air, I will give you also the lapse rate and all that. You find the Weisala frequency. If both are matching, then it will lead to resonance. Okay, we will see what will be the velocity at which it will create some trouble. Then we will move on to saturated air parcel, what will be the condition for stability, and then we cannot stop with this. Once it has crossed the lifting condensation level, whether it will be convectively stable, unstable, partially stable, neutrally stable, there are other conditions. After it crosses LCL, it becomes more and more difficult, so more and more intricate. We will see that in the next one or two classes. Then we will have to go to the second law of thermodynamics, quickly go through the Kelvin, Planck and Clausius statement. After that, we have to get to the Clausius-Clapeyron equation, which will give you the relationship between latent heat and all that. Okay. After all that, some considerations of entropy, then we will put an end to this thermodynamics chapter, which has been going on for such a long time. And then you feel that forever it is going. I also feel the same way. So, because this is the most interesting part, but we will have to stop somewhere. Then we will go to radiative heat transfer, 2 weeks. Then climate change and climate science, 2 weeks, and this will be just a week or so. We have only 5-6 weeks. The dynamics will be. So we are in 26 or 27 class. We'll go to 40 or 42, and then your presentations will be there.